better
to grow
with what we're doing and grow.
Definitely.
With the subject matter of our songs and also just the quality of the music and the quality of our vocals. So we hope that it's a growth. We hope that people see that.
It's something that probably came very naturally too. It wasn't really a lot of deep thought about, oh, material for the second album, we have to take a step, or, you know, I don't think it was really on our minds to try to achieve a specific thing except take a step musically and challenge ourselves.
But you realize that that's not the safest decision. The safest decision is to say, okay, this first album did really, really well. Let's do something that's really, really similar. You took the more difficult decision. Do you realize that? Yeah, and you're ready for that.
You just gotta be willing to take chances, I guess.
Absolutely.
Well, with our video as well.
We have got to talk about that video. Such a great video. Now, I want to know, what's that? Here you are in this really heavy makeup and you're playing bizarre characters, and I want to know, what's the decision to make that kind of a video so that you would introduce yourselves to the American market as just not good-looking guys, but guys with talent, guys with substance? What was the decision behind that?
The decision was just, I mean, we've done how many videos before that? Eight or seven videos. And it was just something different, you know, something...
Whose idea was it?
And it wasn't even intended. I mean, the song's probably, it's not going to be on the American album. It's just for the international album.
Really?
So we wanted, you know, it being our first single off of the international album, we wanted to come in with a bang. Mm-hmm. And just set ourselves, you know, a step up from everything else that we've done.
Was the record company supportive from the moment you presented this idea? Or did they say, hey, come on, guys, this is a little far?
Actually, they weren't supportive. Yeah.
Yeah. So how did you convince them?
But after we shot the video and they saw the results, they're commending us now.
Really? Yeah,
they're glad we stood behind our decision. If you want a party, let me hear you, yeah. You got it going on again. With all the experience that you've had in Europe and in Canada, and we know that millions of albums have been sold, here you are preparing to finally launch and to begin in your own country, which must be an incredible moment for you all. What have you learned from the experience worldwide that you will take into introducing yourself to the United States?
Just the fact that we've had patience, we've worked diligently, and I think...
Perseverance.
Do what?
Perseverance.
Yeah, I mean, we've paid our dues in and out over and over again, and we're still paying our dues now. I mean, we have to start basically all over again here in the U.S., and, I mean... It's just a dream come true finally for us now, because we've done just about everywhere else that we could possibly do except for home. And home is where the heart is for us, so we're finally bringing it back home. And
does this make it more nerve-wracking for you all to know that this is, you know, this is where your families and your friends and this is your home and it's all going to start to happen? Is it more nerve-wracking for you now?
Mm-hmm.
Is it?
A little bit.
So how do you deal with
that? Now that you know that your teachers and your high school buddies and all your friends you used to work with and your peers are watching you. I mean, they've heard about it and now they're seeing it, and to know that they're watching makes you a little extra nervous.
Mm-hmm.
It's nice though.
All right, so the album comes out, major launch worldwide. Everyone's going to be watching at the same time and tuning in at the same time. if this takes off like you hope it's going to take off, you realize that life is going to be very difficult. Everybody's going to recognize you. I mean, here you are at home. If this is the one place where you can walk down the street and still go buy, you know, a sweatshirt or a sandwich, and, you know, I mean, it's, I'm sure you're, you know, people are starting to recognize you a lot more, but eventually that's going to be a thing of the past. How are you preparing for that mentally? Are you thinking of that?
I don't think we're preparing.
We're just waiting. We're just going to wait till it comes, you know.
Yeah. We get there alive surprised. Yeah. Just like when we went over to Europe for the first time. We didn't know what to expect. We don't know what to expect here. So when it happens, it happens, and hopefully it happens big.
Like I said before, a lot of people have said, well, once this really happens for you guys, you know your lives are not going to be no longer your lives. But it's like, it's the sacrifice that we're willing to make because it means so much to us. You know, and I think it's something that, you know, once it does happen, it's going to be very exciting, especially back home here.
Now, I saw you on the Regis and Kathy Lee show, and I could only imagine what you were feeling because I knew that this was the first major American, you know, show that you were doing, the very first one. And I want to know what you guys said to each other before doing that show because, you know, this is a show that your parents can watch, that your friends can watch, everybody could tune in,
right? Exactly what you said. We said, like, right before we went on, I would turn over to Brian, I'd say, we're on Regis and Kathy Lee.
And then I was telling him, I was like, you know, I was telling Kevin backstage, I was like, I've got like cotton mouth, man. I'm like nervous. And he's like, and he turned to me and he patted me on the back and he's like, how many, he's like, you got to look at it like this. How many times have we been in front of a camera singing on TVs? Like, this ain't nothing. Like, and I was like, yeah, okay, we'll go out there. And I was like.
Bass group is bringing their fame home and they're doing it in style with a new album here making their first U.S. television debut singing Quit Playing Games. Please welcome the Backstreet Boys.
Once we were out there, it was fine.
It was fine?
Yeah. To us, living in the U.S., and, like, watching shows like David Letterman and Regis and Kathy Lee, you see all the humongous stars that they got on there, and, like, we just consider ourselves still normal, you know, guys. Uh-huh. So when we're on that show, we're like, wow, you know, that means we're kind of sort of on the same wavelength as the other people that they have on the show. It's just like, wow.
Another group, Backstreet Boys, and boy, they sound just terrific. As we said earlier, big hits over in Europe and in Canada as well, and now starting to take over the United States.
Conquering their own country for a change.
Yeah, I love the stories of how you got started, how you tried to get started, singing for various music executives. So tell us some of those stories.
We'd sing basically anywhere we could, restaurants, restrooms,
elevators. If you know a guy was sitting at a table, you'd go up and
you have to break through because they get inundated with so many groups.
Kind of weird because
very weird
when Kevin was talking about, you know, and Brian was talking about, you know, it's the same kind of show. We've done this many times. We've done the same kind of shows over in Europe and internationally in Canada and stuff like that, but we've never, I don't think, realized how much of the importance it was. You know, it's the comparison.
For
like
sure.
I said, like, I mean, like I said, I'm sure we've done shows that have been,
bigger
than that, but since it wasn't from our home country, we didn't exactly, we couldn't relate.
Playing games with my heart.
Playing games with my heart.
Before you tell us.